Decimal places are a way of extending the base 10 number system so that it can represent amounts that are in between whole numbers. For example, in the decimal number 5.32, the decimal component is 0.32 and the whole number component is 5. Where 5.32 is greater than 5 but less than 6, thus the decimal number 5.32 is in between the whole numbers 5 and 6. The decimal number system is based on representing numbers using power of 10, and the place value of each digit corresponds to a power of 10. For example, in this number, the place or digit immediately before the decimal point represents the place value once. Number places count bigger as we go left of once. As we go left of once, we will get place values tens, hundreds, thousands, and other consecutive place values. For example, in this number, as we go left of once, the digit in the third position with respect to the decimal point is occupied by 7, for which the place value is hundreds. Thus, the position contributes 700s as one of the quantities to sum the number. Starting from tens to follow hundreds, thousands, and other consecutive place values right after the decimal point, number places count smaller as we go right of the decimal point, like parts of something that are less than 1. For example, in this number, as we go right of the decimal point, the second position with respect to the decimal point is occupied by 8, for which the place value is hundredths. Thus, the position contributes 8 hundredths, which is equal to 8 over 100, as one of the quantities to sum the number, where 8 over 100 is a fraction which is less than 1. If we consider the decimal number 2364.587, we can get that the position immediately before the decimal point is occupied by 4, therefore the place value for 4 is 1s. As we go left of 1s, we will get the digits 6, 3 and 2 consecutively, and for them the place values are tens, hundreds, thousands respectively. As we go right of the decimal point, we will get the digits 5, 8 and 7 consecutively, and for them the place values are tens, hundreds, thousands respectively. Thus, the decimal number is equal to 2 thousandths plus 3 hundredths plus 6 tenths plus 4 ones plus 5 tenths plus 8 hundredths plus 7 thousandths. All numbers can be written as decimals. For example, the number 4 is equal to 4.0, and it can also be written as 4.00, 4.000, etc. Adding zero placeholders at the end of a decimal does not change the value of a decimal. For example, 63 is equal to 63.00. Similarly, 63.1 equals 63.10 equals 63.100. In order to obtain fraction from decimal, we can apply place values and fraction addition. For example, if we consider the decimal number 26.5, we can apply the place values and we can write that 26.5 equals 2 tenths plus 6 ones plus 5 tenths. Now, we can write that the equivalent fraction for 2 tenths is equal to 2 tenths over 1, and the equivalent fraction for 6 ones equals 6 ones over 1. So we have 3 fractions to be added. 2 tenths over 1, 6 ones over 1, 5 over 10. According to the fraction addition, we need to find a common denominator. For 1 and 10, the common denominator will be 10. And to get the common denominator 10, we need to multiply the numerators and denominators with necessary numbers. Thus, we get the final fractions, which are 200 over 10, 60 over 10, and 5 over 10. Now, keeping the denominator same, we will add the numerators, and the sum of the numerators results in 265. So, the decimal number 26.5 is equal to the fraction 265 over 10. The numbers that are represented by decimal numeral are the decimal fractions that are the rational numbers that may be expressed as a fraction of the form a over 10 to the power n, where the denominator is a power of 10 and a is an integer, which is formed from the decimal number by omitting the decimal point only, and n is a non-negative integer where n is equal to 1, 2, 3, and so on, when there are 1, 2, 3 and other spaces or numbers after the decimal point respectively. For example, if we consider the decimal number 2.65 equals a over 10 to the power n, then n equals 2 for 2.65 because there are two spaces or numbers after the decimal point. And a equals the integer 265, where the decimal point is omitted. Therefore, 2.65 equals 265 over 10 square, where 10 square equals 100. Similarly, we can get that 0.125 equals 125 over 1000. Here we can write that 125 over 1000 equals 125 over 125 times 8. Therefore, the equivalent fraction for 125 over 1000 equals 1 over 8. Here are such values to remember to make our problems easier regarding the conversion of decimal to fraction. For example, as we have done earlier, that 0.125 equals 1 over 8. Similarly, 0.4 equals 2 over 5, 0.75 equals 3 over 4, and so on. Now, if we want to get the equivalence of this quantity, it needs time to set each digit in the calculator or doing it on the scratch paper. Rather, we can do it in the following way utilizing the table. We can write that the quantity equals 2 over 3 times 9 over 8 because 0.6666 equals the fraction 2 over 3, 1.125 equals to the fraction 9 over 8, 0.3333 equals 1 over 3, and 0.75 is equal to 3 over 4. Thus, we can get that the quantity results in 3. Thanks for watching. Perceive, persevere, practice. Do not forget to like, subscribe and share. Thanking you from High Study Prep.